LeBron James making his return after missing the last 17 games with a groin injury. How did he look early on? Well, there was some struggles. There's a turnover there. Then in transition, Kyle Kuzma finds LeBron. He goes up and gets the lay-in. Then LeBron gets the rebound and finds Kyle Kuzma down the court for the baseline jumper. And we are tied at 14 apiece in the first quarter. Moving to quarter number two in the post, LeBron James steals the ball from Montrezl Harrell. So a little defense. Then LeBron with the assist to Lance Stephenson for the three-pointer. Then LeBron finds Kentavious Caldwell-Pope for the three-pointer. And the Lakers up by six at that point. Later in the second, Rajon Rondo to LeBron for the little lay-in. He had 5 points and four assists at the half. And the Lakers led by one at the break. Third quarter now, it's Rondo to Brandon Ingram, who finishes under the rim with the slam, just sort of spun around down there and got that done. The Lakers up by 10. Then Ingram finds Lance Stephenson for the three-pointer, and the Lakers starting to open it up. They're up by 14 late in the third quarter. To the fourth now, LeBron hits the deep two-point shot. Not a lot of rise on his jumper in this game. 91-78. Later, Lou Williams misses a free throw, but Boban Marjanovic gets the offensive board, puts it in, plus the foul. He'd make the free throw. And all of a sudden, we got a game. It's 97-95. Lance hits a three-pointer from Rondo, and the Lakers go up by six with just over six to go. Then Lou Williams to Boban, and it's another stuff for Boban, and all of a sudden, the lead down to two, less than five to go. Brandon Ingram misses a three-point attempt. LeBron gets the offensive rebound and finishes under the rim. We're just over 3 minutes left, and the Lakers starting to look good again. They're up by eight. Lou Williams misses a free throw here. Guess who gets the offensive rebound? Boban gets it and puts it in. Then Lou Williams finds Tobias Harris for the three-pointer, and we're all tied at 112, less than a minute to go. Lance Stephenson, an opportunity to put the Lakers up, goes for a quick three, sort of a two-for-one opportunity. He misses that. So it's the Clippers' turn. Avery Bradley, sort of a heave here, less than five on the shot clock, less than 15 in the game. He misses, so LeBron gets the rebound, and it's the Lakers' opportunity. LeBron driving, and Tobias Harris knocks the ball loose. It's ruled the Clippers' ball. You see, it's a close ruling here, but seemed to just come off LeBron's right hand there at the end. So we're still all even at 112. And the Clippers with an opportunity to win it. They didn't have any timeouts, so they had to take it out under their own rim. And so Lou Williams trying to go all the way down court, misses the three-point heave at the buzzer. What does that mean? Of course, it means overtime. In the OT, LeBron gets the layup. He finished with 24 points in his return, and the Lakers go up 114-112. Off a Lakers turnover, Lou Williams drives all the way the other way for the layup. Just so tough to stop his offensive game. Just slithery as he goes to the rim. Then Lou, a jumper this time. Lakers all over him. It doesn't matter when Lou gets hot. It's 118 apiece. LeBron James on the other end. Same score. A buck 20 left. Fading way away and hits that jumper. Then Lance Stephenson drives for the layup plus the foul. Watch it one more time. He'd make the free throw. Play review. Defensive foul on Boban Marjanovic there. And it's 123-118, Lakers in front. Lance Stephenson and Avery Bradley mixing it up here a little bit. Watch on the floor. Lance not liking it. Avery Bradley not backing down. We got a replay for you. Good hustle here on the court from both of them in the late stages of the game. We play on in this battle of L.A. off a Lakers turnover. Lou Williams with his team down three, can't get a shot off in time, and the Lakers hang on in a thriller. Your final score, 123-120.